The National Council for Higher Education was operationalized in 2003 when Uganda only had 3 public and 8 private universities, comprising 11 universities with about 53 other tertiary institutions.
In the year 2003, there were 3 public universities, namely Makerere University, Barara University of Science and Technology, and Chambogo University.
In 20 years of service to the nation, the National Council for Higher Education now regulates 10 public universities, 43 private universities, and over 170 other tertiary institutions. Professor Mary Okwakol, the Executive Director for the National Council for Higher Education, noted that National Council for Higher Education has continuously evolved and adapted to national and international standards and trends and more achievements and developments in the last 3 years.
That in the 20 years of existence, UCHE has operated a total of 252 higher education institutions located in different parts of the country. These include 10 public universities, one university with a separate act, that is Islamic University in Uganda, 43 private universities, 20 other degree awarding institutions.
Professor Eri Katunguka, the council chairperson, revealed the challenges the council encounters. He also mentioned the urgent need to amend the Universities and Other Tertiary Institutions Act 2001.
Especially the number of institutions continues to grow. We request that our ministry continues to lobby for increased funding and staffing of National Council for Higher Education and higher education institutions in general, as well as provision of infrastructure and facilities to allow these institutions to operate.
In her speech, the Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni, applauded the council for its achievements in the 20 years of service. Although there is an increase in the number of institutions in the country, the education minister has urged the National Council for Higher Education to ensure quality education to learners.
While the increase in the number of institutions expresses accessibility of higher education, I want to challenge the National Council for Higher Education to assure the quality of education and guarantee routine monitoring of the institutions of higher education to promote the credibility of our education and products.
Janet Museveni appealed to the council to put more emphasis on programs that solve day-to-day challenges of the society. She pledged to prioritize the amendment of the existing 2001 Act as requested by Professor Eri Katunguka and also work on challenges faced by the Council.
In addition, the Minister of Education and Sports is committed to addressing the challenges of underfunding and understaffing experienced by National Council for Higher Education. We cannot just expect you to do your work failing to empower you to do your work well. So we will all hold hands together and really strive to get you funded and well-staffed.
She further tasked the council to educate society on the challenges of digitalization of the young generation. Janet Museveni also asked the National Council for Higher Education to create an agency in charge of digital literacy.
Young people need shepherding as they explore the internet, so that they are not in the wilderness on their own as they engage in this information age. We need the National Council for Higher Education to be the leader, to boldly and unapologetically expose the dangers of internet usage for the younger generation when unguided or unsupervised.
The National Council for Higher Education is mandatory to regulate and guide the establishment and management of higher education institutions, as well as regulate the quality of higher education, equate qualifications, and advise the government on higher education matters. Report compiled by Sharon Navasidi for the news.